Last time I was mean, and this time I'm meaner. You know, I'll lie, I don't care. But I'll make up a good lie. The person that I think I'm most like is Boston Rob. Seeing Rob here, it reminds me of when he played the first time. I loved him.
Okay.
All right.
All right. A dollar. A dollar that he won't make it to the top, and you're saying a dollar that he'll do it?
He's going to do it.
That's someone I could see myself aligning with until it's time to cut his throat.
Okay, wait. Me and Parvati, we're starving. We're not going to wait on nobody to feed us. We're going to take matters into our own hands.
Oh, my God. These are so good.
Put it in here. Put it in here.
Hey! We got meat.
How are we gonna open it?
With a machete. We'll figure that out later, but we will eat.
We've gotten the first protein. If they don't want to eat it, I don't care. More for me. There's no fire. There's nothing. What else are we gonna eat? It was exciting to win the immunity challenge. We had to do it because we didn't want one of our people to be the first to leave heroes versus villains. Now we're trying to figure out who they're gonna send home and why.
The worst tribe ever put together is the villains tribe.
I should not even be here. I should be with the heroes, because I can't stand Jerry. I hate Cody. I hate Danielle. I hate Russell even more. So any of those four, I'm not going to pick one above the other because I equally hate them all. I'll be like, hey, Russell, Coach wants you gone, and I bet you Russell will believe me and get rid of Coach. And me and Courtney will be saved again.
I'm gonna work my magic and we're both gonna be here on day 22 and day 23.
I told Russell that Coach was talking about voting for him. And Russell's so stupid, he ate that crap up. I'm telling you, he's like, oh my God, I can't trust him. And the sooner he goes, the better. So Russell, he don't know how to play this game. Yeah, he's done good so far, but with me, he don't know what he got himself into.
If my plan to vote out Coach doesn't work,
I think Courtney's going home. If I put a bug in Russell's ear that Coach wants to get rid of him.
But Russell was talking to Danielle a few minutes ago, and the conversation, it looked like it was going back and forth. So I don't know. All I can do is hope that Coach is going to go home, and that's it.
We went to tribal council, and we went ahead and voted out Coach because I told Russell that Coach was going to vote for him. And that's why Coach is probably now out there looking into the sky, wondering where everything went wrong.
Come here, homie. Give me that, homie.
Yeah! My husband is a soldier in the Army, and I kind of felt bad I was without my husband because I'm sure he wishes he was at Outback Steakhouse, too, because we just love Outback. We always go to Outback, but... you know, he's got to do his job, and I got to do what I have to do out here on Survivor.
I want table's turn.
This is what we get for being yes, bomb. Me and Courtney, you know, our morale is really low because it's inevitable that me or Courtney are going home, and I'm really sad because me without Courtney, that's like rice without beans, you know? So it's up to Danielle, Parvati, and Russell who they're going to vote out. You know how some people forgive but don't forget? Well, I don't forgive and I don't forget. The heroes don't know that Russell is the kingpin and that Parvati's his right-hand man. Russell's trying to play up this thing like all these women are about to get rid of him. I hope I get my revenge because it's going to be good.
When I first got here, I tried to tell Rupert that Russell is running this whole show. And anyway, we talked really, really quick, and that was it. I don't want my big mouth to get me in trouble. I still want Russell out bad, but right now I'm stuck with Russell. I'm stuck with Russell. When Tyson went and then Boston Rob went and then Courtney left me, I was like, I'm done. But now that they took out JT and now I can jump to them and be 5 against 4, now's the perfect time for me to make my move. I'm voting for Russell because I've been waiting to take him down for 30 days. 30 days too long. It's time for revenge, and this is for Courtney, Boston Rob, Tyson, and even Coach, who I don't care about, but I'll stick him in there too. If I stay with the villains, I'm top 5. I'm not moving up from there because they're not willing to get rid of Russell. That's why I have to flip to the heroes because I need to get Russell out. Russell, you want Russell gone?
Yeah.
Russell's gone. Candace went and told Russell every single thing that was said, including that I was on board with Rupert, Amanda, and the rest of them. And now we're screwed, and now they won't trust us anymore after this.
At the challenge, Jeff read a clue to the immunity item. So the minute we get to camp, and all of a sudden, people just started running.
We're gonna have to split up. Y'all go on that one.
Harmony! The clue said there'll be a burning bush, and in the shadow, there'll be the immunity item. Candace and Russell start digging where there's this big red bush. But across from there, there's another big red bush, so I start digging. And I see it.
We split the votes.
Russell swears that Rupert found the idol.
Of course I know that's a lie, because I have the freaking immunity idol.
And if they think Rupert has it, that's good for Sandra. So I'm not gonna say nothing.
My uncle is here only because my mom passed away. And he's my favorite uncle. He always helped my mom take care of us. When my mom passed, she was with him. It's been a year and a week since my mother passed. So that's why I write, Mom, send help from above. And my husband can't be here because he's in Afghanistan. So having my uncle here and being here long enough to see him is, if it ends for me, I'm happy now.
Parvati was like, don't worry, Sandra, because I'm not writing your name down, and neither is Jerry. So Rupert is going to go home, even if Russell is upset.
He thinks he's writing everything down.
Mm-hmm. It's day 36, the last day for me to use the idol. I might bring it with me to tribal council, but I don't have anything to worry about. I'd rather not use it.
That's how confident I am that I am not going home.
I played my idol at tribal council, and once we came back to camp, Russell was upset, mad about how we're supposed to share the idol and everyone should know. And I'm looking like, when you found your first idol, you used the idol to save Parvati. We didn't know when you got an idol from JT. I didn't know. So how come the minute Sandra gets an idol, I gotta go tell Russell? He wants to micromanage the whole tribe, and unfortunately, I'm not the kind of person you can micromanage. Sorry. Russell won immunity, so essentially I have to do whatever Russell says because he's wearing the idol. I'm feeling wonderful because regardless, Russell's keeping me around because I'll never get a single vote. But I don't know about that. Although you're trying to focus on the game, you still tend to go back and think about, I wonder what my kids are doing. I wonder what my husband's doing. If I think about my husband, he's out in Afghanistan. Is he okay? Did he make it through today? You know, it's not easy.
All right, y'all, I think I'm going to bed.
What?
You're gonna leave us alone?
Yeah, there's no need to babysit y'all anymore.
He's out there in Afghanistan fighting for our country, and here I am fighting to be the sole survivor, you know. But to me, it's worth it. Yeah, I don't get to talk to him. Yeah, I don't know how he's doing, but inside I know he's okay. I have that gut feeling.
And we're all on our own now.
Yeah. Every villain for himself.
Yeah.
So I have to focus on the game because I came for one reason and one reason only, for another $1 million. And if that makes our life easier, then why not? This is how I hustle. This is how I make my money. I come and play survivor. That's what I know how to do. That's what I'm best at. Coming out here, getting my money, going home. Simple as that.
This out.
I've had issues with Russell from the first day we got to the villains camp. When I would see him take off and I would say, he's gotta be stashing something. How come he claims to have been here before, yet he contributes nothing as far as information? He knows it all, yet knows nothing.
Good work, lady.
Russell is obnoxious. So I took his hat and I threw it in the fire. I don't care. I should burn his sneakers. He could take his bald-headed tail to tribal council. It'll be all right. He could wear his buff on his head. He has a big bald patch right here he doesn't want nobody to know about. But we've been here for 39 days. I've seen it a whole ton of times. Screw it. That's payback for everything he's done to me in this game. I don't care.
What the hell? Yeah, y'all haven't seen it?
No. Did you pack it?
I put it right there. Oh. I know I did.
I don't think it's about the money tonight. I think it's about the title of sole survivor. That's all Russell wants. And if that's what Russell wants, that's what I gotta make sure Russell does not get.
I don't get my hat. I ain't leaving.
Well, we're gonna have to leave.
I don't do it.
There's not a day that didn't go by that I was trying to focus on what's the best way for me to get rid of Russell.
Okay.
And the worst thing of all is that those heroes, each and every one of them are responsible for their own self-destruction.
You do it, girl. Woo!
When I was out here, I had to hustle. I had to make sure all my stuff was in order so that when I went to tribal council, I made it out in one piece. I didn't hide behind no immunity necklace. I never had safety. I had to take care of myself.
Woo! Look at it go wild.
And yet here I sit, final three. I think I deserve it. I want the title of Soul Survivor.